This is Musa Kaleem Keita, the poet of Harlem, and I am on Wall Street. I'm at 100 Wall Street. This is where a powerful businesswoman of black American named Ms. Suzanne Shank, S-U-Z-A-N-N-E, Shank. She has an office in this building. Ms. Shank also operated out of Detroit and Oakland, California. Down the street, and that building on the left, right there on the left, is 99 Wall Street. This is where Reginald Lewis had his first Wall Street office. He went on to own a billion-dollar company, supposed to be the first black American to do so. And Ms. Shank, also a black American, she has an office here. So you have a black American woman and a black American man at useful and powerful positions on Wall Street. Mr. Lewis later moved to 957th Street. His company was BTLC Beatrice. It was a international food company. And this is where Ms. Shank has her office. Up the street is Trinity Church. All of this information has Trinity Church in its center. And J.P. Morgan should be the building on the bottom left. Don't want to give anybody free. The building on the bottom left, the lower building on the bottom left, should be J.P. Morgan's, 23 Wall Street. So we're at Wall Street and Water here in Manhattan. And Wall Street initially was a slave market. Historian J.A. Rogers even mentioned that whites were sold as slaves on Wall Street. And here, the New York, City of New York erected this sign. On Wall Street, between Pearl and Water Streets, a market that auctioned enslaved people of African ancestry was established by a Commonwealth law on November 30th, 1711. This slave market was in use until 1762. Slave owners wanting to hire out their enslaved workers, which included people of Native American ancestry, as they laborers also had to do so at that location. In 1726, the structure was renamed the Meal Market because corn grain and meal, crucial ingredients to the colonial diet, were also exclusively traded here. Slavery was introduced to Manhattan in 1626. Notice I said Manhattan, not Manhattan. By the mid-18th century, approximately 1 in 5 people living in New York City was enslaved, and almost half of Manhattan households included at least one slave. Although New York State abolished slavery in 1827, complete abolition came only in 1841, when the state of New York abolished the right of non-residents to have slaves in the state for up to 9 months. However, the use of slave labor elsewhere for the production of raw materials such as sugar and cotton was essential to the economy of New York both before and after the Civil War. Slaves also cleared forest land for the construction of Broadway and were among the workers that built the wall that Wall Street is named for and helped build the first Trinity Church. Within months of the market's construction, New York's first slave uprising occurred a few blocks away on Maiden Lane, led by enslaved people from the Coromanti and Pawpaw peoples of Ghana. So we're here on Wall Street. Historian J. Rogers mentioned this place as a slave market and that whites also were sold as slaves here, although that sign did not mention it. J.A. Rogers mentions it in his works. And I'd like to thank J.A. Rogers. I owe him a great debt for all of his research and traveling. He is the primary person that inspires me that walked the streets of the United States. Of course, the prophets are inspirational and the great holy men and scholars, but J.A. Rogers is the primary person that inspires me, who walked the streets of New York, walked the streets of Harlem, and walked in our time. Thank you, J.A. Rogers, and I also like to give a shout out to the Rogers family. And we shall continue this little history lesson. By the way, Black Sam's Tavern, or Samuel Francis Tavern that I mentioned in the other video, Francis Tavern is located at what is called 54 Pearl Street. 54 Pearl Street, you'll find Francis Tavern. The reason I had difficulty in telling you what the street's name is because there were no street signs up. I had to go inside the establishment and ask one of the attendees or workers there what is the name of the street. Thank God the person was very kind and friendly. Okay, we're at Wall Street and Water in front of the slave marker. And I'd like to give a special thanks to Paul Robeson, who mentioned that Black Americans created the primary wealth of the United States, and we have a stake in this country, the United States. J.A. Rogers goes further in the book, Africa's Gift to America. Anyone visiting Africa should read that book before they go, and if you can, take the book with you and share the book with people on the African continent so they can know of Africa's contribution, hence our contribution in the United States during our 300 plus or more years sojourn. Thank you very much, and may God be with us all.